Hi friends, today let us discuss equivalent circuits, the fourth topic of transformer. Here the contents of this video are, here we will discuss some equivalent circuits, exact equivalent circuit, simplified equivalent circuits, approximate equivalent circuits and general form of equivalent circuits, and equivalent circuits refer to primary and secondary. Now let us see one by one. First, exact equivalent circuit without IE, without exciting current IE. So these equivalent circuits based on two KVL equations, one is for primary side and second one is for secondary side. See this, these are the equations. So finally this is the equivalent circuit without IE. The first one is primary circuit and second one is secondary circuit. Primary circuit V1 is given, just as we have so many days we are discussing this. V1 is given to the primary side, so that I1 is the current flowing through the primary. Because of that I1, flux phi is produced or induced. Because of flux phi, E1, E2 are induced. And the, because of if the secondary is connected to any load, there is a current flowing through secondary circuit also, and the voltage V2 is the voltage across the load, and in between them there are resistive drop and reactance drop, as we have discussed in the phasor diagrams. So this whole story has to be incorporated by using only two equations. One is V1 is equal to V1 dash plus I1 V1 dash plus I1 into R1 plus JX1, which is equal to V1 dash plus I1 Z1, where Z1 is the primary impedance, so which equal to R1 plus JX1. And similarly this same scenario for secondary circuit also, E2 is equal to V2 plus I2 into R2 plus JX2, which is equal to V2 plus I2 Z2. We have done the same thing in phasor diagram, but without exploring these equations or without discussing these equations. That's it. There is no difference between equivalent circuits and phasor diagrams much. Coming to exact equivalent circuit, in this we need to incorporate IE also. We know that primary current I1 is equal to I1 dash plus IE, where I1 dash is the load component of the primary current, IE is the exciting current. And we again know that IE is IC plus IM, where IC is the core loss component of current, IM is the magnetizing current. So these two facts will be incorporated simply in this manner, where we need to incorporate these things as a shunt branch, resistance RC and XM. These things will be discussed in OCSC test also, based on these equivalent circuits only. In this we need to see one thing here. We have to use two KCL equations, Kirchhoff's current law equations. One is this one, I1 is equal to I1 dash plus IE, where IE is the shunt branch current, I1 dash is the load component of the current. So it has to go to load, or it has to go to the secondary side, or it needs to go to the winding of the primary so that it will go to secondary. So again, this IE, the exciting current IE is divided into two parts, IC and IM. IC is flowing through RC and IM is flowing through XM. So this is the exact equivalent circuit. After that, we need to change here and there, maybe transfer to primary, transfer to secondary, again approximate equivalent circuit and simplified approximated equivalent circuit, all these things. But the main basis is this one. This one is the biggest equivalent circuit, you can call it as. So finally this is called exact equivalent circuit. Now the equivalent circuit referred to primary. How to refer the all quantities to primary? Here let me take the secondary resistance drop referred to primary. I like to take the secondary drop to primary, and this will be done like this. Secondary drop is I2R2, and I need to shift to primary side, as this is the voltage, so I need to shift some voltage drop from secondary side to primary side by using this I2R2 into N1 by N2. This is the voltage transmission ratio. So inverse of voltage transmission ratio is this one, so which is equal to I1 into R2, where R2 is also converted into, sorry, I2 is converted into I1. So I1 into N1 by N2 into R2 into N1 by N2, which is equal to N1 by N2 whole square into I1 R2, which is equal to I1 R2 dash, where R2 dash is the resistance referred to primary, so which is equal to N1 by N2 whole square into R2. Similarly, we can do it for X2 dash also. Now, the total resistance of the primary side RE1 is equal to R1 plus R2 into N1 by N2 whole square, which is equal to R1 plus R2 dash. Obviously, the total reactance of the primary is XE1 is equal to X1 plus X2 dash. And so the equivalent leakage impedance referred to primary is ZE1, which is equal to RE1 plus JXE1. So this is the whole scenario of equivalent circuit referred to primary, how we have to refer them. Now see, all quantities has come to primary side, but we need to represent them as dash. So it has to be represented as R2 dash, JX2 dash, I2 dash, V2 dash, all dash components, even E2 dash. And those should be how they are equivalent, that was already also shown here. And coming to the next part, yes, equivalent circuit referred to secondary. How we need to refer equivalent circuit to secondary? Again, we need to follow the same procedure. The resistive drop of the primary is transferred to secondary. Here some mistake is there. Primary resistive drop referred to secondary. Secondary is I1 R1 into N2 by N1. That means it's a voltage drop. So obviously it has to be transferred accordingly, which is equal to I2 into, need to take off I1 in terms of I2. So that was done. And finally, R1 dash is equal to N2 by N1 whole square into R1. And now X1 dash is like this. Total resistive drop of the secondary is RE2 is equal to R2 plus R1 dash. And total reactance drop is X2 plus X1 dash. And final equivalent leakage impedance referred to secondary is ZB2 is equal to RE2 plus JXE2. So this is the whole scenario when the whole circuit is transferred to secondary. And this is the thing, the transformer become the ideal transformer now, and this has whole thing has been transferred to secondary. Obviously the primary things will get the dash terms. So this is the equivalent circuit referred to secondary. Next, we need to find equivalent circuit in general form. In general, the vector representations represented bars have to be eliminated, and the J term in reactance has to be eliminated, and the dash term for referring to primary and referring to secondary have to be eliminated. By eliminating all these things, the circuit will be like this. Of course, in exciting current IE, IC, IM, I2, V1, V2, all these have bars, but that should not be there. Actually, this is a mistake. So we need to remove those bars for getting general form of equivalent circuit. Here, very simple, primary resistance inductance, secondary resistance and inductance, and shunt branch, and voltages and currents. That's it, not more than that. And all dash terms, everything will be removed. And this is the general form of equivalent circuit. Next, approximate equivalent circuits. How to make them approximated? So these are the approximate equivalent circuits. That means we have simply transferred resistance and inductance to one side, maybe primary side or secondary side, This first one is referred to secondary side and second one is referred to primary side. These are called approximated equivalent circuits. Keeping the shunt branch as shunt branch, that means the all resistance and inductances should may be from to all resistances to left side and all reactance to left side, or all resistance and inductances to right side, then it will be called as approximate equivalent circuit. And coming to this simplified approximate equivalent circuits, here we need to simplify this. That means the resistive branch is neglected. Once the resistive branch is neglected, this is the scenario. The whole resistive branch is, shunt branch is neglected. So this is finally we will get RE and XE only. Next, and one more simplified approximate equivalent circuit is only representation of reactances. That's it. So the last thing will be used in many of the power system applications. That means if the transformer is used in the power systems, so the transformer is simply represented as an inductor only. That's the whole story of equivalent circuits. If you like this video, please like it. If you like to share it, please share this video. And kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel and try to press the bell button so that whenever I upload any video, you will definitely get the notification whenever I upload it. Thank you. Thank you so much.